Let's do this slowly.
Off grid.
Oh man, it tore the shit out of that.
Homesteaders Jim and Nancy have fought back the forest to check up on their friend's abandoned cabin.
Yo, bear!
But hungry bears emerging from hibernation may have beaten them to it.
Be careful, he might be in there sleeping, Jim.
I know. Well, there's tracks.
Sure is. Look here. There's his prints. Those are pretty fresh.
Real fresh.
Can you tell how big he might be?
He probably stands up 6 foot, 6.5 foot, probably about 250, 300 pounds, something like that. Let's go on inside. Be careful, them steps are a disaster.
Oh, yeah, it looks slick. What?
Get your gun out.
Nancy and Jim have reached the abandoned cabin where starving bears, fresh out of hibernation, have wreaked havoc, looking for food.
Bear! Yo, bear! I'm sorry, I didn't mean to scare you, honey. Thought you were used to me doing that.
I thought you were coming one around here. No, he's gone.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, at least he didn't all over the place.
Looks like he's been sleeping on the bed. My goodness, yes.
What if he knocked this back over?
He didn't break any dishes.
Well, I guess there's a good thing about it.
How'd he get in, Jim?
Hell, I don't know. The windows are fine. The door's fine. Oh, he come up through that escape door.
Man, I can't hardly believe how a big bear like that can get through that.
The original owner wanted a little trap door in the floor in case that there was an emergency where he had to, he'd forgotten the key or something and had to get into the cabin.
This is claw marks here. You know, you can see how wide his print is. It's 4.5, 5 inches wide.
You're gonna have to really secure that hole.
I've seen these bears come through the floor. If they smell bacon grease, stuff like that, I've seen them tear the whole side of the building down just to get in. Why don't you go get that hammer out of that shed and we'll see if we can nail it down.
All right.
What a disaster.